guys. In this video, we'll be discussing about Nyquist stability criteria. So first of all, let us talk a bit about Nyquist plot. So what we know is we have an open loop transfer function that is basically g of s. Okay. So whatever value of s you put in the transfer function, you will get a corresponding value of gs. That is, for different values of s, you will get different values of gs. This can also be called as mapping. So when we try to draw Nyquist plot, what we take is, we take a something called as Nyquist contour. What is Nyquist contour? It is a set of values in the s plane, that is a set of values of the variable s for which we will determine gs. And once we have determined gs, we will plot all those values on a graph in order to derive something which is called as Nyquist plot. Okay, so basically this gs or this function is a mapping between Nyquist contour and the Nyquist plot. Is it fine? Nyquist contour is nothing but it is a set of values in the gs plane for which we will derive the Nyquist plot. So Nyquist plot is what? It is the set of values of gs which have been derived from the Nyquist contour. Okay, this is Nyquist contour, this is Nyquist plot. Now when we want to derive the stability, we have to see the poles in the right half plane. That is why Nyquist contour is always chosen as the entire right half plane. So how do we take the right half plane? We take the right half plane in the form of a semicircle whose radius is infinite. If this is infinite radius semicircle, we can cover the entire right half plane, that is your Nyquist contour. So we can see the number of poles and zeros that are lying in the right half plane. So there are two things. First of all, Nyquist plot is always for open loop transfer function. Okay, whenever we are drawing Nyquist plot, we are considering open loop transfer function. So it is drawn on the basis of OLTF, but it can also give stability information for closed loop transfer function. Okay, that is, we are drawing it for open loop, but we can derive the stability for closed loop. So first of all, let me explain to you what is the Nyquist stability criteria. So in Nyquist stability criteria, we say n equal to p minus z, where first criteria, I am telling you there are two criteria. First criteria, n is number of encirclement, that is how many times you go about a point, that is number of encirclement, but here of origin. If you see the number of encirclement of origin, it will be taken as positive for anticlockwise, negative for clockwise. P is open loop poles in RHP. And Z is open loop zeros in RHP. Now this criteria many of you might not have heard about, because most of the times what we read about is the encirclement of minus 1 plus J0 point. So that is your second Nyquist criteria. The second criteria is same, n equal to p minus z, but here n is number of encirclement of minus 1 plus j0. Again, you will take positive for anticlockwise, negative for clockwise. P also remains same, open loop poles in RHP, but this z will change. Z will now be closed loop poles in RHP. So, if you want open loop stability, that is the open loop system to be stable, P must be 0. If you want closed loop system to be stable, then in this criteria, Z must be C. If there are no closed loop poles in right half plane, closed loop system will be stable. If there are no open loop poles in right half plane, open loop system will be stable. So these are two Nyquist criteria. Now let us see one problem that appeared in GATE 2017 in ECE paper based on Nyquist criteria. So what was the problem? Actually, it had given us a transfer function. This is the transfer function that was mentioned to us. And based on that transfer function, this Nyquist plot was also given. So these two things are given to me. And it has asked number of closed loop poles in RHP if K lies between 0 and 1. So see, it is talking about closed loop poles, which means we have to check the encirclement of minus 1 plus J0 point. So if you see this K, K lies between 0 and minus 1, which 0 and 1, so minus K will be less than minus 1. What I mean to say is, this distance is actually K. This is 1, so K must be less than 1, okay? It will lie inside 1. Which means this minus 1 point is not encircled. Minus 1 is not encircled. Which means number of encirclement of minus 1 comma 0 is 0. Okay. So if you want to apply Nyquist criteria, you need two things. You want to find out this Z. So you need P. But still I don't know how many open loop poles are there in RHP. Now this is the open loop transfer function. If you want to find out number of open loop poles in RHP, one thing that you can do is apply Routh criteria on the denominator. So if I want to form Routh array, so what are the coefficient? S to the power 3 coefficient is 1. S to the power 1 coefficient is missing. So it is 0. S square coefficient is 3, S to the power 0 coefficient is 2. So what is S to the power 1? 3 into 0 minus 1 into 2 minus 2 by 3. S to the power 0 is 2. So there are two sign changes, one here and one here. So two sign changes, which mean P equal to 2. That is, there are two open loop poles in RHP, and from this condition we know there are two closed loop poles in RHP. Now, one thing that you have to be careful about here is, here S is has the power 3. If you might have misread it, you might have read it as S square plus 3S plus 2. In that case, you would have said that the system is stable because for second order, mind you, till second order, you can see if all the coefficients are present and all the coefficients are positive in the denominator, system is stable. That is, there are no poles in the right half plane if all the coefficients are positive and all are non-zero. But here, the power is 3 and you see there is one coefficient missing. So the rule that I am telling, all coefficient non-zero and all coefficient positive is only applicable till second order. From third order onwards, you have to apply the Routh criteria. Otherwise, an easier method. What could have been the easier method? Suppose I wanted to find out number of open loop poles in RHP. I will use another criteria. So, number of encirclement of origin is also P minus Z. P is open loop right half poles. Z is open loop right half zeros. So, if you see this transfer function, the zeros lie at minus 2. That means Z will be equal to 0. There are no zeros in the right half plane. Now, you see number of encirclement of origin. One encirclement like this, then one again like this. So there are two encirclements, both are anti-clockwise. So N0, 0, that is origin is encircled twice in anti-clockwise. So you will take it positive. Now substitute these values here. 2 equal to P minus 0. From here also I get P equal to 2. So I did not need to apply Rau-Hurwitz criteria. I could have derived P equal to 2 by looking at the number of encirclement of origin. And then by looking at encirclement of this minus 1 point, I can derive number of closed loop poles in RHP. But remember, this is a very crucial information 0 to 1, because then only I know the location of minus 1 point, and then only I know that it has not been encircled. And when this intersection is dependent upon K, suppose if K was greater than 1, minus 1 would come inside. That means the stability is conditional, it is conditionally stable, because the position of minus 1 will depend on the value of K. So if these intersections are dependent upon the value of K, then the system is said to be conditionally stable. Is it fine? But then you have to check whether it is stable or unstable based on the value of K. So there are two Nyquist criteria. One which is very commonly used, that is encirclement of minus 1 point. But it is rarely used, that is the encirclement of origin. So keep in mind both the criteria and the difference between the two. Thank you.